Our first competitor, please welcome Big Mac, Cedric McMillan.
Ugly in his sin. This is best star 82. 943 tiny rooms, one view.
Ladies and gentlemen, I present to you your 2013 Olympia class. One of these gentlemen will be named Olympia champion.
Pray heaven, good grief, hungry belly, bright gold on his teeth.
Folks, so they line up this big, this deep, not even an argument anymore, the most competitive Olympia in history. I certainly cannot do this alone. I need a co-host as big as this lineup. Ladies and gentlemen, my co-host for the press conference, the menace, Dennis James.
Thanks for coming back. It is, for me, an honor to come back here to host this show with Bob together, with all these athletes. And I feel so much better than compared to last year, because I know there's no Masters this year, so there's no way you can trick me into doing any other shows. So I'm just strictly here to handle business with these guys. Thank you very much for coming out.
And for those that were with us last year, remember Dennis was right here in this very spot where the audience actually made a decision. Dennis put it in your hands that he was going to compete on that Masters stage. You did a very triumphant show for you, Dennis. Congratulations on that.
Almost
is that
got,
it?
Almost got divorced. Yeah, that's it. That's it. My wife forgave me, so I'm good. No more shows. This is it.
Do you want to put it to audience vote?
No more shows. This is it. Just like Michael Jackson said.
I never thought the name Michael Jackson would ever come out on the Olympia stage, but we've got bearded fat chicks, we've got Michael Jackson. Let the games begin.
I used to have an even better Jerry Curl than that.
All right, well, let's get down to the business of bodybuilding in the 49th Olympia. Phil Heath. You're two-time champ. Will it be three-time champ when the dust settles?
Thanks for all the fans that showed up today. Really appreciate it. I think, like Bob said, this is going to be the biggest and the baddest Mr. Olympia contest of all time. We have three Mr. Olympia champions along with four multi-winner Arnold Classic champions. And, you know, everyone up here has won something. So we're all champions up here, and we're definitely all fighting for, you know, that Sandow trophy. But to answer your question, I would be really ignorant to say that I'm not wanting to win. Especially after winning the last 2 years. So yes, of course, I train hard, I train smart, and I'm definitely having a great time being the champion, traveling around the world, meeting many, many fans, and having an awesome experience, being a part of the sport of bodybuilding. And I hope that, of course, when the dust settles, I will be the three-time Mr. Olympia champion. You know, I definitely feel like I have the ability, and I definitely put in the work.
Well, Phil, normally we kind of, work our way into the conference a little bit, get a couple fluff questions out to get things going. This year's too competitive for that. We're going to get right to the jugular. But if I'm mistaken, now correct me if I'm wrong, I might be. Probably not. But Ty Green. Phil, if I'm not mistaken, we were at the athletes meeting last night. You guys get your credentials and your tickets and all that kind of stuff that we have to, the business we have to do. And then you have the opportunity to sign posters. They get for Robin Chang for the Olympia and all that. They're the big official posters. Everybody signs them. But am I missing something, or did Kai Green not sign him as Mr. Olympia?
I don't know.
Well, I think we have the man right here. Do we not? Kai Green. How are you doing, Kai?
Hello!
Kai, now, again, correct me if I'm wrong, but I'm never wrong. Did I not see you sign the poster that said Kai Green, Mr. Olympia, underneath it?
Yes, you did.
What's up with that?
I intend to be a person of very few words.
No.
I can show you better than I can tell you.
Hey, if you want to show some muscle here, you're not going to get an argument out of these people. What do you think, Dennis?
Well, I think he just got up. He just woke up from backstage because he was sleeping for about 45 minutes. So I was like, give him a couple more minutes to wake up. On the other hand, for me, it's so good to see Big Jay Cutler back on this stage. Jay, remember, very well, last time you came here on this stage, you put your sand out right here on the table. This year, it's only a bottle of water. I'm not saying that you don't have, you still have four sanders at the house, but are you planning on putting that sando back on there on Sunday morning?
Yeah, four. Five. Come on, Jay. Yeah. I came back. Obviously, I want to thank everyone for coming and supporting. I think it's going to be the biggest crowd appeasing Olympia in a very long time, if not ever. And I was in the press conference last year. I sat over there and I watched all these guys up there, and of course, first year away from the Olympia stage in over 10 years. And I decided after that I wanted to get back up there. And of course, you know, barring the injury and everything was recovered, I'm back up here. I'm very blessed to be able to be healthy and be able to stand with all these guys, you know, not just, you know, obviously Phil and the guys that are going to be the highlights of the show. I'm just, I'm very fortunate to be able to be competitive and be healthy. So I want to thank everyone for coming out and supporting my run for the fifth title here.
Hey, and, Jay, I want to obviously delve deeper into that, but I'd be remiss if I didn't use that phrase once again. And I can't gloss over this here, Phil. Mr. Olympia. Ty Green?
Yeah. Everyone up here is trying to be Mr. Olympia.
Well, I know that. Listen, everybody's trying to be Mr. Olympia. Absolutely. Everybody's here to win. He just said, he signed the poster as Mr. Olympia.
I mean, I guess he can do what he wants. I mean, some people would find that disrespectful, some people not.
Do you?
It doesn't really matter because...
Do you?
No, because it doesn't matter. At the end of the day, he can sign whatever the hell he wants. I mean, it doesn't really matter to me. Obviously, I didn't care. All I care about is winning my third title, you know, creating this legacy that I want to live, and crushing everybody's dreams. Just like Ty.
Crushing anybody. The other thing about one person, the one person I talked to yesterday that got third place last year, but you don't really hear a lot of talk about him this year. Mr. Sean Ronan right here. Came out of nowhere in 2012, won numerous shows, got third at the Olympia, went to Europe, won some more shows, and now not a lot of people talk about Sean Ronan. What is Sean Ronan gonna do this year with Ky Green, Phil Heath, Jay Cutler coming back, Dexter Jackson, all these guys? Where does Sean Ronan fit in this year? Tell me what you said last night. Don't try to sugarcoat nothing here.
The wait is over. Thank you guys so much for coming out, support all these great athletes. It's been, to say the least, a great journey. And very happy to be back here on this stage. Not just as a number or as a spectator, but I've worked my ass off this year to be where I'm at, and I'm looking forward to getting out of here.
That's not what you said last night. I quote, I'm here to win this year.
Yes, I am. I mean, I worked very hard the past couple of months to be here. Since October last year, you know, I've dedicated, you know, all that time to be back here.
I see you went to California. You left home to train with Charles Glass. Was that the magic formula that you needed?
And here comes the time when, you know, you realize how far you can take yourself. And you know, I trained very hard for many years, and you know, at the end of my journey, you know, I had to pack up and come to the West Coast. You know, and work with Chris Acedo, and everything's been going great, and you know, figure out the best way for me to prolong this journey was to come out here and you know, train with Yoda. I live in Charles Glass and you know what he's capable of doing. And I came out here and said, here I am. I took myself as far as I can and you know, kind of need help to you know, finish this journey. So yes, you know, I'll train very hard to be here and yeah, I'm gonna win.
All right, thank you, Sean.
Well, Sean was third last year. We've got guys that were in the top six returning, but here's a gentleman to my left, one of only three on this stage now to have held the Olympia title, the Blade, Dexter Jackson. In fact, you heard Dennis putting the question to Sean. You know, a lot of guys obviously getting the hype. Phil, of course, he's the champ, and the return of Jay, and Big Ramy coming in, his first Olympia and all that. But you won the Olympia title. Dex, should your name be up in that mix? People forgotten about the Blade?
Man, I'm always forgotten about him. I always have to shut people's mouths up. Same thing will happen this year. You know what I'm saying? So I just let my physique do the talking for me. But I will say this, you know, when Ronnie Coleman and Dorian Yates and those guys competing, they were above their time. You know, they were like unbeatable. Could come off a little bit and still win because of the, you know, conditioning and just sheer size they had. I don't see that, you know, I mean, great lineup, but it's so close. If you're off, you can get beat. It's no runaways in the show. See what I'm saying? So that's the way I see things.
Is the Blade still sharp enough to take a title?
I'm always in condition. That ain't the point. But I tell you what, if you get caught slipping, I'm gonna get you. I ain't the biggest guy in the world, but look here. I'm tough to deal with, I'm gonna be 100%, and I'm very hard to beat. So if you're off, I'm coming to get you.
All right, thank you, Dex.
And he's definitely getting me because I'm off.
Way off. Not with that jacket, bro. You're on. You're right on. Jay, let me get back to you real quick. Like I say, obviously, a four-time champ. A stride for five this year. Obviously, you've got your hands are full. But, Jay, we've seen, obviously, a lot of speculation over the year. Our friend Sean Ray even speculating you wouldn't even make it to the Olympia stage, but here you are.
Shows how much he knows.
Jay, obviously, your training this year has been much different than previous years. This is the first time in your storied career that you've been off the stage for nearly 2 years now, obviously with injury and, of course, didn't compete last year. But what was the motivation to come back? Obviously, you could have rested on your laurels. You're going to go down as one of the greatest Olympia champions in history. No question about that. Four Sandows, Arnold Classic titles. You won every title in this business. What was the motivation to come back for a fifth time?
A lot of reasons, actually. You know, I sat back and watched the show last year, and of course, you know, watched Phil win the second. And, you know, I obviously miss competing, but, you know, the fan response, you know, I still travel a lot, and I actually put more time into doing more promotional stuff overseas, and I got a huge response, and all the response I got was, you know, the fans wanted to see me back on the stage. So, you know, I not only that, I think, you know, 2011, I didn't have the opportunity to stand up there at my full potential. Obviously, I had a bicep tear before, so... I thought that was, you know, an opportunity to be able to compete. If I could get back up there healthy, it took me, you know, that much time to get back up there and be able to train at the full capacity. But this Olympia is a little different for me than probably a lot of the guys sitting up here because, you know, I've been here as long. I think Dexter and myself have been competing at the Olympia the same amount of time. But, you know, this is the first year where without Joe Weider, who obviously carries the name of this show, and in this... I wanted to, you know, probably dedicate this. I had a very good relationship with Joe Weider. He's the one that actually moved me to California to become the Jay Cutler you see. I mean, he gave me the opportunity to be someone that was in the magazines and give me the lifestyle and create the opportunities. So I think, you know, Saturday night is going to be a huge, huge time for everyone to give a tribute to Joe Weider, who started this contest and started this whole thing for all these people up here. For the fans to see.
All right, thank you, Jay.